Hello student, this is Soni Das, your English teacher, and today we are going to read and discuss about the second chapter, that is the poem with the title The Ant and the Cricket. We will read the poem and discuss each and everything about the poem. So let's start reading and discussing about the poem. So student, here is the poem. The title of the poem is The Ant and the Cricket. And this poem is adopted from Aesop's fable. Aesop was actually a Greek storyteller, and he wrote a story in the form of poem that is called fable. In this kind of story or poem, actually the characters are non-human. That is, the characters are animals, or they may be other natural things like sun, moon, air, water, etc. And through these characters, the poet actually conveys some moral or some message. So in this poem also, we will see the moral or the message after reading the complete poem. I will read the poem and I will explain the poem stanza wise so that you can get the poem. So let's start reading the poem. A silly young cricket, accustomed to sing through the warm sunny months of gay summer and spring, began to complain when he found that at home his cupboard was empty and winter was come. Not a crumb to be found on the snow-covered ground. Not a flower could he see, not a leaf on a tree. Oh, what will become, says the cricket, of me? So today, the poem starts with a description of a silly young cricket. Cricket is an insect, and it is said in the poem that silly young cricket was accustomed. Accustomed means he was in habit of singing all day long through his happy warm day in summer season and spring season. So he was just making merry all day long in the summer season and spring season. But when his happy days ended and winter arrived, that time the cricket found that he had nothing to eat, not a crumb of food. Why? Because it was immensely cold weather. Everything was covered with the snow. Not even a flower or a leaf could be seen, just because they were all covered with the snow. And so he didn't find anything to eat. That time he became very worried and started thinking what would become with him if he would not have any food. Now come to the next stanza, that is, at last by starvation and famine made bold, all dripping with wet and all trembling with cold, away he set off to a miserly ant to see if to keep him alive he would grant him shelter from rain and a mouthful of grain. He wished only to borrow, he would repay it tomorrow. If not, he must die of starvation and sorrow. Finally, when the cricket became restless because of starvation, he was out of hunger and he was not having any food outside. So finally, he decided to go to an ant and ask for help. There he knocked at the door of ant, and when ant came outside, he promised her that if the ant would help him with food and shelter, the very next day he would repay it, means he would return it to ant. And if ant would not help him, then he must die of starvation and sorrow. Now come to the next stanza. Here, says the ant to the cricket, I'm your servant and friend.
But we ants never borrow, we ants never lend. But tell me, dear Cricket, did you lay nothing by when the weather was warm? Quoth the Cricket, not I. My heart was so light that I sang day and night, for all nature looked gay. You sang, sir, you say. Go then, says the ant, and dance the winter away. Thus ending, he hastily lifted the wicket and put off the door, turned the poor little cricket. Now here, the ants give a very important lesson of life during its conversation with the cricket. Ant says that ants neither borrow from somebody nor lend to somebody. Ants are hardworking creatures and save for the future. Then the ant asks the cricket what it was doing during the whole summer. Did he not save anything for his future? Then on this question, the cricket replied that he was just dancing and singing all day long in his happy summer and spring day. Because he was so happy in the good summer and spring day that he was just making merry and just keep on spending his days like dancing and singing and roaming all around. And thus he passed his happy summer and spring days. After listening to the reply of the cricket, the ant says to him, oh, you mean you dance the whole day in spring and summer season? Then the ant advised the cricket, try dancing and singing once again to pass this rough times of winter season. Maybe your dancing and singing will help you to pass this winter season also. And after uttering these words, the ant closed his doors and left the poor cricket outside. Now the poor cricket was standing outside without any help, and he was regretting now. Why didn't he plan for his future? Now come to the last two lines of the last stanza. Folks call this a fable. I'll warrant it true. Some crickets have four legs and some have two. Here in the last two lines of the last stanza, the poet actually says that people call this a story, but the poet ensured that it is actually true. Some crickets have four legs and some have two. Here, some have to refer to the human beings. Okay, so through the story of the ant and the cricket, the poet wants to convey a message to all human beings that among us many are there who just spend their good times in making merry and do not plan for their future or bad times in future. So children, through this short poem, we get a very important lesson of life that we should enjoy our happy moments in our present time, but we should not ignore our future also. We should be hardworking, careful and active to plan and secure our future.
Now let's summarize the poem. The poem is about a cricket and an ant. A cricket was very careless and he was just dancing and singing and roaming all around during his good days in summer and spring season. But when it arrives winter, what happened? He found that because of cold and snow, there was no food for him and there was no shelter to him. Now he became very worried about himself. So he went to an ant asking for help, but there the ant gives
him a very important lesson of life. And what ant says to him? It says to him that ants are very hardworking creature, and it neither borrow from somebody nor lend to somebody. Then the ant asked the cricket what was he doing in his summer and spring days. Then the cricket replied that he was very happy in his summer days. So he was just making merry and he was just dancing and singing all day long. And he, in this way he just passed his all summer and spring days. After listening to this answer from the cricket, the ant says to him, okay, if you passed your summer and spring days in this way, then you could also pass your winter days in this way. So go on singing and dancing and just pass your rough winter days also. After uttering these words, the ant just closed the door before the cricket and left that poor cricket outside. Now the cricket was standing outside and he was not having any food or help. And now the cricket was regretting on his own behavior that why didn't he plan for his future. So children, now the poem is ending. We have read all the poem and I have explained the poem for you. Even if you have any doubt, you can ask me in between 12 p.m. to 1 p.m. at noon. And what you have to do, you too have to read the poem aloud in your own voice. I hope this explanation will help you. Thank you.